Welcome back to KXAN News Today. The Austin Independence Business Alliance holds its first ever local Biz-to-Biz Expo this week. It's meant to encourage local businesses to buy from each other. The group's executive director, Rebecca Melanson, joins me in the studio this morning to talk about it. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, so let's talk about the Austin Independence Business Alliance. Who are you? What do you do?
We are a 14-year-old nonprofit organization founded here in Austin, of course, and we support and market local businesses. Okay. We currently represent over 800 locally owned businesses.
Wow.
And a large part of what we do is advocacy.
Okay, which leads to this, because you said, okay, how do we make sure that these businesses are utilizing each other? Were you finding that they weren't reaching out to each other and saying, hey, you've got this service, I've got this product, let's get together?
A lot of them are. Our members really work hard to utilize one another for their own business, because every business has purchasing needs of mm-hmm. goods and services. But a lot of times people are thinking and focused on consumers and not necessarily their own business. So now we want to spread the word outside of our organization. And we're issuing the local Biz-to-Biz challenge.
Okay.
We want every business in Austin, local or not, to take 3 vendor contracts that they have and shift them to locally owned businesses. And if they have a bunch of contracts with locally owned businesses, shift 3 more.
You
can always find 3 more.
Okay. And were they saying, hey, we need an expo like this?
Yes.
Where we can get together and figure out who's what and where?
Exactly. So the first question is, who's local?
Yeah.
How do you really know? Well, we're the source for who's local. We're the only organization in town that has pure local businesses as members. So for consumers, we do quite a bit. We publish our Indy Austin magazine twice a year. It's all over town. It's easy to find. But for businesses and B2B services, what we had was just our listings. So we thought, let's do an expo.
Yeah.
Let's invite people. It's fun. We'll have a little music, a little food, a bar, of course, it's Austin. And then come meet some of the most amazing business owners who can provide goods and services for your business.
And really what that does is because that keeps the dollars circulating in
the
more wealthy a community is, the more that dollar circulates.
Exactly. So what's really important to Austin is our local economy. There are an estimated 50 to 60,000 locally owned businesses in Austin.
Wow.
That is a wow.
Yeah.
That's really big.
So for folks who say, this is for me, what are they going to be able to see and do there?
Okay. We have 24 vendors that range everything from, printing services to office supplies to legal services to just about anything that you need. We even have a water tank company that's going to come in. So we have a little bit of everything. But we also have 7 15-minute quick talks by some of our vendors.
Okay.
So you can come over, sit down, just 15 minutes. It's not a long,
it's like a quick
long
pitch.
Lecture. It's a quick pitch.
Yeah.
And hear what's going on in industries such as how they can help you with marketing, credit card processing, legal services, all kinds of things.
Yeah. And do they have to be members of the Austin Independence Business Alliance?
Oh, absolutely not.
Okay.
So anybody's invited.
Okay.
Anybody's invited. And we ask that you RSVP. But there's no charge. It's totally free, except for the bars, cash bar, but the rest of it's totally free.
Okay, so then tell folks then how they can find you to get more information.
If you go to our website, it's www.ibuyaustin.com. You'll see right there on the homepage on the right-hand side the local Biz-to-Biz Expo logo, like this one. Okay. Just click it. It has all the information, and you can RSVP.
Rebecca Melanson. Good Creole name there. Am I saying that right?
Yes, you are.
Melanson.
Good job.
I love it. All right, October 5th, 3 to 7, AFD Theater and Hall. Thank you, Rebecca, for joining us.